Good evening, everybody. This is Sweat, and finally we're taking a look at the Aftermath DLC on my channel. Now, this is Scanner Barclay's gameplay. Of course, I do not have a PS3. I do play on PC, and I do not get access to Aftermath until next week, like the rest of us. So it's just a few days, actually, considering this is going up on Friday. And, of course, I'm excited because I'm looking at this gameplay, and I'm looking at these maps and the new weapon. And first and foremost, let's check out this new weapon, this new crossbow, which I'm sure you guys have seen on probably a lot of videos. But, of course, this is the first look on my channel, and it's something I haven't really checked a lot of. I haven't really looked at a lot of YouTube videos on the crossbow, not a lot of extensive gameplay on the crossbow. So, kind of surprised to learn that it's a one-hit kill. I mean, not really surprised to learn it's a one-hit kill. Kind of, I'm not sure how I quite feel about it. I know a few people have been complaining quite a bit about how, I wouldn't say complaining, they're just not very happy about the fact that you can get destroys with the explosive tips on aircraft and vehicles and such, where I think that may be kind of a bit much. I mean, it seems to me like it should take a few hits to take down something like a little bird or a jet or anything like that. Excuse me, I'm still trying to get over being sick. I'm getting there, but I'm starting to feel better for those of you that I won, so I appreciate it. But, you know, of course, it is what it is. We'll probably see what DICE does about the crossbow based on feedback, like they do everything else. Interested in learning some more of the weapons balances. Haven't really checked those out a whole lot. Of course, you guys know I've been grinding in some other games, but I'm really excited to get back on PC. I'm really excited to get back to Battlefield because, as you guys may or may not know, I have hundreds upon hundreds upon hundreds of hours played on Battlefield 3, and it's nothing against the game. It's a great game. I just needed to play something else because I've played so much of it that, hey, you know, it was time for me to get a hold of something else and just and get excited about getting back to Battlefield. And that's what this Aftermath so far has done for me, because the maps look exactly like I expected. They look exactly like I wanted. They look like the Karkin maps and just look like they're just blown all to hell, which is what we want to do to Karkin maps anyway, right? I mean, we want to play the Karkin maps. And we just want to destroy shit with our RPGs and our tanks and our C4 and all that kind of stuff. They've kind of taken the liberty and done that for us, and they've kind of done that for us already. But of course, I'm sure that means we still get to destroy quite a bit of the environment. I'm sure we get to destroy quite a bit of these buildings and everything anyway. So I'm excited about it. I really am. And if, you know, only a few days. Lord knows I'll probably stay up all night on Monday to play it on Tuesday night, only to find out that it doesn't come out until Tuesday afternoon. But of course, if you guys didn't realize or haven't followed me on Twitter or anything like that, this week, yesterday was my last day of class for this semester, and which means finals start next week. Finals begin for me on Monday and don't end till Thursday. So I unfortunately will not be able to play nearly as much of the Aftermath DLC as I would like on that first week. And of course, after finals are over, I really need to spend some time with my family and my girlfriend, who I've unfortunately been neglecting for the past couple weeks due to do some out-of-town trips and of course school as well. So not going to be playing as much Aftermath as I would like. Definitely going to be playing Aftermath though. Definitely can't wait to get back on Aftermath. Try out this new crossbow, see what kind of freaking wicked montage feeds I can get with the crossbow, see if I can knock those jets out of the air with one shot. I've seen a couple of videos where people have shot jets down with just one shot from the explosive tip. Not sure how I feel about that as a pilot, but of course I haven't really flown too much since I dropped the controller. I'll be honest with you, I don't think I've flown. I might have tried flying one or two times with keyboard and mouse, and it's ended so abruptly that I didn't even jump back into it. So real quick, I would like to thank Scanner Barclay for sending this gameplay from his PS3. He sent me loads of gameplay that I had to sort through and find for you guys, so I couldn't possibly post enough. You have to check out his channel, and you guys can do that. The link will be in the description below for his channel. I encourage you, if at the very least, please go to his channel and thank him for sending me the gameplay for Aftermath, because I really appreciate when such a small channel like that would agree to help me out, help a larger channel like myself out, and it means a lot. So please, again, visit his channel. For those of you who have missed some videos, that's actually a Diamond AN94 that went up on Machinima Respawn just today. So I hope you guys are able to check that out. And if you missed my Battlefield 3 in 1080p, then you probably missed the last Military Monday, and that video is on the bottom right. Of course, that is in Extreme HD and 1080p. It's something that I'm really pushing towards. So thank you guys again for watching. Have a great day. If you're new here, just click that subscribe button. If you enjoy the video, video, hit that like button. It really does help the channel out. And last but not least, check out Scanner Barkley. Tell him thank you from me because I really do appreciate it. Have a great day, guys. Look forward to seeing you again soon.